Some say it's just a few hours, but it could cost hundreds of thousands of dollars and lead to more dangerous travel.
A fight with the feds is heating up over their move to change the hours of operation at the port of entries between the U.S. and Canada.
Valley News Team's Ryan Laughlin tells us what's at stake and why border towns are pushing back.
At Bernstrom Oil, that sound means business is good.
U.S. Highway 59 is a main bloodline into Minnesota.
For Charlie Bernstrom, there's concern traffic on Highway 59 could be slowing down.
Like a slow winter day all year round.
For a place that sets their hours to match the hours of the port of entry,
Canadians are a huge part of the economy.
Concern is growing.
It just seemed like it was so rushed and really no regards for the local economies and communities.
Customs and Border Protection proposed to limit the hours at the Lancaster and Roseau ports of entry. In Lancaster, they want to close things up at 4 p.m. rather than at 10 at night. CBP officials say the decision is solely based on declining traffic. They say in the past 7 years, traffic has dropped nearly 50%, and there's a greater need at other Minnesota border crossings. CBP officials called it fiscally irresponsible not to make changes. But in town, they see the economics a little differently.
So probably about $300,000 a year in lost revenue.
Bernstrom says more travelers will take the interstate and skip Lancaster altogether.
But I don't think what they do realize in the summer and like on Fridays and the weekends, that number's a lot higher. So that's when it's really gonna hurt.
CBP officials say they wanna hear from everyone before making a final decision. They also say they're open to the idea of having longer seasonal hours as a compromise.
Everybody you talk to is opposing it.
People here hoping they can keep the doors open as long as they can. From Lancaster, Ryan Laughlin, Valley News Live.
And the pressure is being put on Minnesota lawmakers to fight for border towns. Governor Mark Dayton wrote a letter to the regional CBP director opposing the change of hourly operations. In his letter, he said limiting hours will cause health and safety harm as well as economic damage to Minnesotans. U.S. Senators Al Franken and Amy Klobuchar have also been involved. The proposed changes would take effect on January 7th. However, CBP officials say that they'll make their decision in the next couple of weeks. Officials also say that we'll be reviewing North Dakota's port of entries later this year.